We got game number 4 coming at you here. Sinkey Sports versus Reason Gaming. Of course, Reason on the Legion team now. Sinkey Sports on the Hellborn side. And Sink currently up 2-1 here in this best out of 5 coming at you here. Again, the challenger fight here for the King of the Hill. Week number 6. The winner will play Stay Green on Thursday, who's awaiting in the title fight, who's currently on a 2-game winning streak, actually. Not only did they defeat BMG last week, we casted a 5-game series, a great one at that, as expected. But the week before that, even, they actually took out Sink Esports to claim the title for themselves and start the 2-game winning streak they're on. So Sink looking for some revenge in that sense, but Reason Gaming proving to be quite the obstacle here in between, as they took the last game and, again, looked very good doing it. So here we are, the next game, and a lot of last game, it was had to do with just a very interesting, kind of somewhat of a unique strategy coming out there from Reason with the Swift Blade and the Electrician and everything. So this time around, though, Rhapsody and Moon Queen seems a little more straightforward here with their pickup so far. Torture and Pestilence, the first couple of pickups for Sink Esports, of course. And then we sell the band, so.
I mean, very standard draft so far. Nothing really standing out. It is a kind of a last game in the series feeling for Sink, so they're probably just going to take it safe. And Reason Gaming knows they can't lose another game, so also going with this kind of a safer route, picking the Moon Queen, who hasn't really not been getting picked that much. I've been surprised. It was a Stay Green series that was the same thing. Neither of the teams were especially interested in picking her up. But I suppose as we get closer and closer to the land, we're going to see more of these hard carries come in. And Nymphora picked up against the Moon Queen. I think that's a great decision here from Sink, because Moon Queen is a hero that is going to want to split farm, and his team is going to have to stay split up for a little while longer than most other heroes, at least.
Yeah.
So this is kind of throwing Sink off of the strategy. I would love to see heroes like Keeper of the Forest get banned out here, because you don't want to give Sink the possibility to push with a Moon Queen, because that's basically the two things that she's really good at: early team fights and the late game. Okay. So removing Keeper, who she synergizes really well with, I think is a must in this draft. But we'll see what Flensmeister does.
We will indeed. As far as extra time is concerned, dipping into that a little bit, already done at 33 seconds on the Legion side, but the first ban, of course, being that Drunken Master here. Tundra is going to be the next ban so far, and you know, Tundra is one of those heroes that you're going up against an Nymphora, for that matter. You know, you speak of, it's, you can't really say anyone's really counter to Nymphora, but if there was one hero, Tundra would definitely have the potential, of course, with the Shiver, being able to expect ganks incoming and see them even with the teleport. So definitely has that counter potential. So a good ban there, to say the least.
Yeah, definitely. I agree with you. It's interesting because I'm looking over the heroes and what would I ban is kind of the thought that I'm going through. And really the biggest two threats to them is early aggression that shuts down the Nymphora, and suicides that she cannot box out. Like Ikrinix, I think, is a must ban. Something like a Madman can be a big pain, but it's unlikely that they pick Madman and Moon Queen onto the same team. So I think Grinix and Keeper would be my two bans here. He goes for Kraken, which is a hero that Reason are really comfortable with. Zane plays it a lot. So it makes sense. It makes sense. Yeah. I just, for me right now, it's kind of like, okay, what do I ban, though, between the Grinix and the Keeper? I don't really want to give them Keeper because it gives them the possibility of pushing. And Grinix can be a real pain for an Nymphora at the pull, as he's pretty much impossible to zone out. And unless you have, like, a Puppet Master uplaning with you, it's going to be really difficult for Nymphora to get XP at the pull without the Grinix coming over there and snitching the creeps.
So here we are at that final ban now for Sink Esports. What are they thinking here? Are they thinking along the same lines or something even completely different, perhaps? He's like saying the Grinix and the Keeper are the two candidates possible here for Sink to possibly ban. So anyways, down to 20 seconds now. And going to pretty much use a good amount of the time here. Bramble being right-clicked over there for Sink Esports. Again, he's kind of a hero we've seen sprinkles of here and there as far as potential. And they go Warbeast ban. So, I mean, that fits the push potential, definitely.
Yeah.
Banning out.
I don't really agree with it. I don't think there's any way that Reason was picking Warbeast here. With Moon Queen already on their team, and they're going up against an Nymphora. Mm-hmm. It is such a pain. I think you have to shut down the Nymphora somehow. And a good suicide pick is the way to do it, not a war beast.
Yeah. Well, they do get the bubbles to go within the end here now.
It looks like a suicide bubbles, but it could still always be a tri lane.
Yeah.
At pebbles here would be pretty strong. Gauntlet's open. Though I don't really like the Gauntlet pick this game. I mean, he's good against the Pestilence because he removes the sprint with his ulti.
Mm-hmm.
But I think I'd prefer something more carry heavy, something that can really take off and make a lot of space for the heroes if left alone. Kronos is on the board too. I've seen some interesting trends with that in TMM. As soon as he hits level 2, he's basically he has a stun and a slow, so he's really strong. Yeah. But they do go with Elec. They did go with the last game, so keep the momentum up.
Yeah, I mean, again, its potential is great. We talked about the last game. We saw the possibilities last game. He most certainly has that potential again. So, and this time around, it seems like will he set up in more of a dual lane setup, or they have options?
I think tri lane.
Yeah.
So yeah. They definitely have options. Yeah. I think either it's a Moonqueen tri lane long lane, or they're gonna go with the Elec tri lane long lane and put the Moonqueen short lane.
Okay.
And then have the rotation happen from the two supports. I think Elec, I talked about this before, Elec in a 1v1 lane against whatever they put short lane would be pretty strong. It looks like they're actually farming MOA or Tort, though.
Yeah.
That's going to mean Pestilence is short lane. So, interesting loaded of mind games here. Because you got a double range lane and you got the... They have so many ways they can do this.
Yeah.
And they're not giving it away until the game actually starts.
Okay, I was going to say, yeah, the Flintmeister was on in 4 there for a second. Yeah, I was like, what is going on? Okay.
Yeah, all right. So MOA on Flintmeister. They should definitely send this middle. It's probably going to be a Bubbles there, but you just got to access those Ancients early. He's so good at farming them, and those are what make the hero. I really don't like putting Master Roams in the short lane, unless you're going to push really hard,
yeah,
or you're going to rotate him to the middle lane early. But it looks like they're going... to put him short lane and have the Pestilence middle after all.
Mm-hmm.
Not a decision I agree with.
All right, well, we'll see how it ultimately does shape up and obviously from there how it progresses. But you got Reason Gaming off the bat. They got Rhapsody, Moon Queen so far heading towards the bottom. Electrician is going to be joining them. And then even Pyromancer. So four heroes kind of going down here to protect the bottom side. Madman's going to be the only one heading in that direction, as he does have that one ward of sight on him, so we'll see if he's able to get that place. Pandy placed the very early ward of sight here, speaking of that, at the bottom rune area and into the jungle, so could very likely spot Madman kind of coming in here. Maybe even get a counter ward off as a result, but for the time being. So it looks like, again, though, Sync Esports, or Reason Gaming, they are setting up for a defensive trial in here almost. Of Pyromancer, Torturer, and Pyromancer Rhapsody and Moon Queen, excuse me. So, a lot of chat going on here. As we said, these two teams are very knowing of one another and, you know, good friends in the end. So, there we go with that ward of sight, but again, he's spotted doing that, so could safely assume that's going to
no
be.
No counter ward, though.
Not on them? Oh, okay.
Yeah, they bought a circlet on instead, which I remember. I think Senders went on rants on this on Honkast before, so I'll keep it short. But it's just simply not worth the gold. Pretender's Crown is just not something you want to get on support heroes.
Yeah,
support heroes it's just so important to get maximum efficiency out of your gold, and that is one of those items that is really not good until you upgrade it.
Gets that early on, doesn't have a rev ward as a result, and no counter ward. So yeah, that camp's going to be blocked now, and. Again, we'll see if they eventually get the ref ward to take care of it, but that's definitely the difference here between a 30-second spawn or maybe even like a 2 to 3 minute spawn now.
Yeah.
At that spawn camp.
They did actually end up sending Master Roamer's middle. I like this much more than what it looked like they were doing initially. Gives them away the access to Ancients and also the possibility for Nymphora to just stack and pull and just shut down the Electrician entirely up top. Mm-hmm. But Pyre's actually rotated up here.
Yeah, this is an interesting position to be in. Torturer's actually in an awkward spot almost, but okay, he's going to be fine. I thought they were for sure going to maybe look to dive him. He is just eating through the trees up here. Jeez. Yeah, he put himself in a very awkward spot there. But in the end, he is going to be fine as he gets away And no kills happening. But, yeah, how about that rotation? They sent Pyromancer all the way to the top lane. And almost catching them off guard there, as Torture actually did not see that coming, I'm pretty sure. That's why he got so low in the beginning. And actually, he is still kind of in some trouble right here.
Yeah, he's gotten himself into kind of an awkward spot. But the thing is, if Freezen Gaming chooses to dive him, then Four is going to have time to rotate over. And that could be really, really bad for Reason if they lose the heroes up here. Really, all they need to do right now is just not die, and they're going to get ahead. Because their Pestilence is going to be a little bit pressured. They're forced to make a pretty bad pull here, which is going to push the lane. And that means they're going to be able to get XP in the tower. Oh, beautiful stun from Slap.
Jeez. Yeah, that Zeal stun just hitting. It's not going to matter, though. Pyromancer is going to live. Obviously, no chain of reaction to stand. In fact, Torture is going to be turned on right here. Double stun coming out. There's a nuke from Electrician. He's going to chase. Zeal stun hits, though, and needs to be careful not to chase too far.
Really sloppy there from from Saint. He could have. That was a kill, definitely, for them if he would have just not overlapped his stun. Oh. He could have gotten probably another auto attack and a half off before he needed to stun there. But, yeah, no real shame.
So, a lot of action at the top lane to start things off, but no Bloodlust kill just yet. There's also been good action at the bottom lane. KZ is actually taking some good damage down here. He's nearly out of regen. That's obviously very important. He's down to two Tree Eaters left. And once he especially runs out of that, he's at least being able to kind of peek in there, maybe get a couple creep kills here and there. You see what Razzy's doing. You're going to use the stock and get some harassment, but then quickly fall back. So, again, the regen being very low, that hurts.
Yeah, he really doesn't need that much more gold, though. All he needs to get is get to his bottle. If he can get to his bottle off of his regen, he's done great in lane.
Okay.
And considering he has one Tangle left and all he needs is two creeps, it should be doable for him now. Mm-hmm. Might have to use mana, though, but he has two stocks, which is basically two guaranteed creep kills if he chooses to use them that way.
Yeah.
No, there we go. There he got his bottle. So, yeah, no, he's doing pretty good in lane. Penny needs to open up that pull. He failed the counter ward somehow, even though he saw where he has to place the ward.
Oh, wow,
Yeah, not really sure about that. But, yeah, no, I think the interesting lane, as per usual, is the odd lane out, which is the top lane. And this is where the game can get decided. And Four is rotating quite a lot, not really making her presence felt at all in lane top. And they're getting a little bit under-leveled on the two supports that are top now. Mm-hmm. Pyro's level 3, Alex level 3. They could go for a kill here onto the Pestilence if they're brave enough to dive.
It would be a very ballsy play, but here we go. Actually, speaking of diving, Impalement going to be coming out of Pyromancer. There's the chain reactions follow-up, and Infor is coming in as well. He tries to dodge Dragonfire, but he hit it. There's a Phoenix Wave. Not going to be another beautiful Zeal stun from Slapped right there, and the Impalement's doing a lot of work. The auto attacks will finish out Pyromancer, and it was damn close, but in the end, it's going to be big time in favor of Sync Esports. Good job kiting around the outside by Mickey, and down falls Electrician. These Zeal stuns are from Slapped. First one was beautiful. I didn't get a kill. This time was extra beautiful, and it sets up two kills.
No, really, really well done. That was a beautiful play from Mickey with a mana battery there as well. I actually didn't even think about that, but really well timed. Saved it for the last second. The auto attack was in the air. I was like, okay. So Pestilence is dead. But then comes a perfect mana battery there. Saves him from the last auto attack and keeps him alive.
Yes.
It's just a small thing, but what happens is Pyromancer falls back and stops chasing. And instead of dropping another extra auto attack that would have gotten the kill on him, he'd fallen back and couldn't turn around to get the kill. And then he just regened up with his tangos and a health potion and went back into the fight. So, small thing makes a big difference.
Definitely, definitely does. Madman, in the meantime, again, he's abusing that stock, just getting some harassment auto attacks or creep kills. Even he's going to take some good damage right here, but again, he goes back into the stock and then falls back. I was getting at the bottom lane. Speaking of, again, Moon Queen is having a fantastic time at the same time. You got 37 and 11, now 38 and 11. Moon Queen, the Whispering Helm is just about finished already. She's only gone the little red booties here to start things off. But it seems like this is kind of your classic case here. We got a Moon Queen basically getting free farm. But in the meantime, you got a Pestilence, a Master of Farms doing pretty well. You know, things going overall decently here at the same time for Sync Esports. So, it's where's that adjustment, where are we going to go in the next couple of minutes here is going to determine a lot, I'm sure, as far as kind of picking things up. So, but for now, you think Sync Esports needs to look to address the Moon Queen just yet, or, you know, just be patient with it for now?
For now, they can be patient. They got the Nymphora that as soon as she hits level 6 is going to apply a lot of pressure. And this is an interesting play from them. They haven't been stacking Ancients, and I was just about to start whiny about it. But what they're doing is they're sending the Nymphora to 1v1 the bubble's middle now and send the Master Arms into the jungle to clean the stocks that Nymphora has got during the early game.
Okay.
And this is good for both these two heroes, as Master Arms really isn't a hero that wants to stay on lane for too long. He wants to be farming stacks for that acid. And Nymphora getting a solo lane to get the level 6 faster. Really good.
Now, not so good for Sync. Obviously, top lane, Mickey gets picked off, and a lot of that has to do with actually Rhapsody teleporting to the top lane and definitely caught him off guard as he threw in some staccato stuns to set up the following stuns on top of that. So, yeah, big pickoff on a Mickey at the top lane, and again, just solid rotation coming on their part. Speaking of these stacks, they're actually going to steal one of the stacks right here, is Electrician and Pyromancer. So definitely making some good use and some good time of that in the meantime. Master of Arms, though, he is up to about 305 gold per minute here. So, again, his GPM looking solid. And if we're not able to get level 6 either for the time being, as you said, she was in the middle lane. But with Bubbles hitting level 6 especially, doesn't want to risk staying there too long. Top lane again, though. They're going for a kill on Pyromancer. Taunt goes up. In comes the Impale. Look at that damage, man, especially with a Swarm debuff. Doesn't stand a chance. Electrician's going for the counter kill, but yeah, here we go. Bubbles coming in with the kill field. Rhapsody's here as well. Only level 4, but the Disco Inferno goes down. They get the one kill in the 4. They're going to get the 2 kills on a Torture as well. Pestilence thinking about it, but it's just too risky to chase after that Electrician. And it ends up being a 2-for-1 for Reason Gaming, actually. Bottom lane, no. Just some more harassment. Madman,
there was honestly no need for either of those two support heroes there to die. Master Arms had his ulti up, and didn't use it throughout that entire team fight up top. So could have definitely saved one of the supports, and had he done that, the other two could have definitely turned around with the impalement damage that Torturer had up. So big misplay from Flensmeister, and these are the small team fights that normally decide the game. Yeah. This time it didn't end up too poorly, as he got a kill before it, but another mistake like that could cost them the game. Needs to be on top of those ults.
That is a good point, because I think you even mentioned it a couple of games ago where, you know, as a team, maybe not knowing as more of a carry kind of Master of Arms team, and, you know, Flensmeister, so how much experience does he have playing a hero like Master of Arms? You know, he is kind of in this concept that he's constantly switching between the guns and, you know, keeping in mind that global ultimate presence, being more of that support focus minded rather than, you know, just being the carry and, you know, focus about damage and whatnot. So, perhaps coming into play right there, but you look back at the top lane, hey, keeping that Swarm debuff up. Off to the side, Torture is here, but unless they get the perfect angle, I don't think they're going to make something of this.
He's in a pretty good angle on the Rhapsody
there. There's the ported from Nymphora, so they look for the perfect angle, but do they get it? The Impale Stun misses, but the Seal Stun hits, but now Pets is in a launch. Okay, he does Impale Stun, so I was going to say, I thought he used it, but no, he still had it. Deep with the Master Call comes out, he puts the Swarm debuff on, he purges him, no, he purged actually. Pets is right there, slowing him down. So he's going to keep the Storm debuff. Mook reports in, but nope, no more follow-up now. Sync's fine resetting here.
Yeah, a bit of an early Master's Call there. He needs to save it for the last second because of the Electrician Purge. The timing is just crucial of this ability. He used it early there, and then he didn't have mana for the stun that would have gotten the kill in the bubbles.
Yeah.
So small thing, once again, it's just they're building up. And Reason Gaming, I mean, they're not really getting any momentum or anything, but you're going up against the Moon Queen, and you gotta play tight. You cannot make those small mistakes.
Bottom lane again, though. I keep feeling like there's action down here, but no, it's just Madman stalking in and stalking away. So, no, not so much. And he's managing, again, very solid farm, actually. 220 gold per minute, not bad at all for a suicide Madman down there. But at the same time, Moon Queen, 350, and she actually finished the Steam Boots versus any of the Mystic Vestments, so she was on track to get an early Whispering Helm. But decides to go for the full Steam Boots first.
And Vestments. When you're farming a Moon Queen like this, the Vestments is a really big investment. Because otherwise she would have had the Whispering Helm right now and she could be farming the jungle. Instead she's going to have to run back bottom and force Pyromancer out of the lane.
Yeah.
Oh, they could go for a kill here.
Ooh, yeah, the Moon Finale was ready if just something hit right there. I mean,
the 4 TP though as a response, and in comes both Torture and Nymph.
Yeah,
stun onto the Moon Queen.
They're in trouble. There's the Zeal stun. Good coordination from Sync. Not enough for the kill. A big Dragon Fire stun coming out right there from Pyromancer. Here comes the turn now. Deep of the Master Call going to be used on a Madman. In the meantime, Torture will die. Madman still looking for something else. Barrel roll coming out. Bubbles in trouble. Bubbles will fall, and the Dragon Fire stun is going to be dodged. There's the Zeal stun hitting both sides on Pyromancer. One more auto attack. Yes, he will get it. Moonbeam not enough to finish off Nymphora. So Zapdos going to double tap, but here comes Rhapsody actually to nowhere. Panny gets a kill, but at what cost here? Madman's hit here, but the Disco Inferno is going to be too much pressure, and Madman has to fall back. So finally, it'll all be done there at the bottom lane. But yeah, holy crap, that was so close to a dead Moon Queen. wasn't to be, though. It's a lot of exchanging, but Moon Queen lives there for a reason.
Yeah. Moon Queen lives, and Pestilence continues to farm towards that Blink Dagger. So, overall, I think this was good for Sync Esports. They're winning time for Pestilence. Pestilence isn't being pressured, as he was like the main target of pressure from Reason so far in the game. So, gets him a couple of free CS at least, or relatively free. Only has the electric to fight up there for it. So,
yeah,
that's pretty good. He's not too far off the Blink Dagger yet. And now, and once he gets that, that's when they get dangerous.
They want to try to make a playoff here, and this could be something, definitely. Barrel roll coming out. There's a purge. Will it be in time? Dragon Fire's done. The combo. Pyromancer, not going to be enough. He has an ultimate. Not enough for the kill on a Pestilence. Man, a better reuse. And now Pyromancer's going to fall. So you can tell he's kind of baiting that out almost. And, yep, again, Pestilence stays alive due to the Master Skull at the last second. Not even necessary in the end, but still, just in case. So, Sync Esports, a couple of big kills on their part. And are they going to be able to push this top tower? Probably not. Bubbles and Rhapsody are kind of nearby. And the tower does still have plenty of life. So, but obviously, the movement game definitely picking up big time. And again, going back to Mickey, he just about has a Portakey now. And especially we got the Nymphora presence on top of that. It's just going to continue picking up from here. So, yeah, very good start here for Moon Queen. But is it good enough? Is what it's, again, the kind of the usual question. But in this game, I guess, no different here when it comes down to it for Reason Gaming at this point. So, there's the Portakey purchase. Nymphora is ready with a TP. I'm curious to see if we see something right away or if this is going to be a, you know, be patient. Okay, well, there you go. Right away, right next to Moon Queen. Oh, my gosh. Talk about perfect placement. Now, she is somewhat tanky here. As we're talking about, Barrel comes in, though, and, yeah. That's a dead move.
Slap overlapping is done there quite a lot. The Pestilence stun is really long. It's 2.5 seconds, and then after that, it applies a 2 seconds slow.
Yeah.
So you have a lot of time to get that Nymphora stun off, but he uses it right away for the burst, and it works out because Madman was there, but it could have been really, really ugly otherwise.
Yeah. Oh, going they're for more, chasing. Though. Yeah, Pyromancer now in trouble. Kelfield just kind of stalled them. Impel stun hits both, though, and down goes Pyromancer. Will they dive further? Berserk is up for Madman. It is going to wear off right there. Song of the Scene, new coming out. Bubbles to make some jukes right here. Shell Surf, Impel stun, it didn't hit, but the Seal stun hit, though. Again, Slap coming through right there. The auto attacks to follow. Rhapsody porting in, and here come the follow-up ports, including Moon Queen. So maybe Sync Esports staying around a little too long here. Electrician chasing, but no, he just purged himself. Yeah, he can't purge that off. Bubbles coming in, not going to be able to stop him, though. And Nymphora, oh, never mind, gets spotted.
Yeah, the vision from the Shell Surf going to secure them killing Nymph. But yeah, overall, it's not looking that good for a reason. Their Electrician's really not that farm. The Bubbles really doesn't have anything at all.
Yeah.
And Moonqueen is the only one that has somewhat good farm, but it's by no means a dangerous Moonqueen. So, as long as Sync keeps the pressure up and plays an aggressive game, they should have this game quite bagged right now. I'm surprised at how poorly Flensmeister is doing, though.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, he's, again, you kind of wonder if it's just maybe just different with the hero or whatnot, whatever, but in the end, another kill in the bottom lane, obviously very important on a Moon Queen right there, and even Flensmeister happens to get credit for the kill on top of that, so.
It's, I mean, that's great.
Yeah. All of a sudden, he has 1,900 gold saved up with his farm already, so looking pretty good here.
Yeah, he is. I suppose they haven't really been stacking ancients effectively, and that's really the reason for why he isn't sitting at 500 GPM or anything already. He had a lot of triple stacks in the jungle, so I was expecting him to be really, really big this game. But without the ancients, he simply just doesn't take off fast enough.
Yeah.
Dangerous TP coming in from Reason. He's going to go through with it, but he has an Invis rune on Bubbles.
That's why he was so ballsy. But at what cost? Your Impel stun from Pestilence. Holy crap. They just melted away as if they weren't even there. Again, so crazy. It made sense because of the Invis, if anything, but they had no clue Pestilence was also there. And he was ready to jump in. And perfect timing. So, yeah, Reason Gaming really now in that hole. And now Moon Queen isn't even having that good of a game anymore. All the way down to 270 gold per minute, and it's just all sorts of picked up here for Sync. So, you know, pending some complete mistakes here from Sync Esports and everything, it seems like they're in a very good control of this game right now, and it's just going to get worse. Rhapsody is going to be picked off here. Maybe not, actually. Electrician, good save. Enough of a save. Never mind. Jailstar comes out, and actually they will get the kill in the end. Pyromancer bubbles. They're chasing. It's not going to be enough, though. Sync is playing just a little too safe here.
They're going to turn around for a kill, though. Pestilence is making himself ready for it. He's waiting for the double. Is he going to find it? Yeah, there we go.
There we go. Swarm goes up. Pyromancer, Firewall coming on top of that. Here comes the move. There's a lot of creeps nearby, though, absorbing some damage. But they will kill Madman in the end. So good bait coming out right there.
3 seconds. Peasant's Blink is going to be up soon. They're going to go back into the fight.
They want to.
I know Mickey wants to. I know Mickey wants to. He's waiting for the flight. 4 seconds. Actually, it does look like they're falling back. All right. What a shame. Yeah, no, they found the double stun there, but this follow-up just simply wasn't close enough. Flansmeister didn't have any mana at all, and then decided to mana himself, actually, a little bit of a misplay, but getting a free kill here, anyways.
Yep, they're the stay around long enough, and sure enough, they do find the opportunity to get a kill on the bubbles right there, so it all works out in the end. Firebrand just purchased by Master of Arms, by the way, as he's cleaning out Ancients.
Yeah, he has a regen rune bottled up, so should be all good. Be able to farm these Ancients and regen up to max HP right afterwards.
Support was pushed to the top. They better get this kill now. They really better get this kill, which they definitely are. But wow, I mean, he survived a lot longer than I thought he would. I mean, he was pushed up very far by himself. So that was just the decision-making support getting a little antsy there in terms of just making some plays himself. But in the end, does die for it. Pestilence, Nymphoros porting in. Oh, jeez, yeah. Rhapsody's in trouble. They're running right into a trap, and Rhapsody explodes right there. Moon Queen will be fine, though, so it's almost good that she spotted them that early, because Moon Queen might have been in worse position if it wasn't for that. Madman, in the meantime, he's going to find bubbles here. Suck of the Sea comes out. Berserk is activated. Moonbeam hits. Chase not going to follow, though, and in the end, may just group up mid or maybe go to Congor. Obviously, Madman great at those Congors.
Yeah. This is one of the points I stressed, though, during the draft and how important Keeper of the Forest was. Because at the moment, Reason Gaming are stuck. They're playing as an Amphora, so that you can't really be split farming. You want to be pushing. That is the way to deal with it. That is the optimal way to deal with it. Unless you crush her in lane. So, they didn't crush her in lane. So, they got a Moon Queen who needs farm, but they got no space to do it.
Yeah.
And they can't really push, they can't really force any fights, because if they go start first pushing towers, they have no minions to tank them. So all Sync really needs to do is put Master of Arms there, and it's not going to happen. So just a really, really rough position for them. They really don't have the late game. They don't have the farm to just try and force it either. So at the moment, Reason Gaming just are at the feet of Sync. It's Sync decides what happens in the game, and unless Sync decides to throw the game away on purpose, then I don't see it happening for them.
Yeah. Yeah, I definitely don't see that happening whatsoever. Reason Gaming, we've talked about it before. I mean, they are definitely a team that's not known for conceding. They definitely will kind of stick this out at least for a little bit longer for sure. But the chances, it seems gloomy. And actually, here we go. Pestilence, they're going to find an opportunity once again. Nice take cover right there, actually. He does pop
the
Shrunken Head. Yeah, the Gore proc definitely still coming through. But actually, he's realizing quickly needs to fall back. They don't really have the best numbers right here. Nazeel's different in for us, saving the day for her. Torture chain reactions in the background. Bubble's kind of diving a little too far, and he's forced to fall back.
Still has the kelp field. Interesting. Neither team really confident to take the fight here, but we see more players coming in from Sync, and this should be an easy fight for them now. Beautiful takeover.
Yep, dodging again, but will it pay off this time in the end? Protective Melody coming out, actually, and that will help save the day. Madman actually resurrecting right there. From the token of life, Pestilence is picked off. They will get the one kill in a Master of Arms. Torture is going to drop as well. And, well, I mean, Reason Gaming, that's...
Talk about the throw.
I mean,
a couple of seconds ago, neither of us thought it would be possible. But, yeah, Sync really overextending themselves there into the Rhapsody ultimate, really turning that team fight around. Probably would have been a clean swipe otherwise. But, yeah, keeps Bubbles alive, and Sync don't really see the Rhapsody ult. They do believe it was used from Fog. And when that happens, you as a player, you get this weird kind of a buggy look where you don't really see the ulti circles. All you see is the shiny thing around the heroes.
Yeah.
So it's kind of hard to tell for another second or so after she uses it. Sync player is not getting any damage out for pretty much half the duration of the Rhapsody ulti, which was huge in favor of them.
Oh, barrel roll does connect bubbles. There's a skill stun.
He gets it again. Beautiful. Wow, Slap has been playing a fantastic Nymph so far.
He really is. Now, will this result in a kill's the question? You see the Offensive Master's call even. Talk about a hero to have it on Madman, and yes, it will finally result in a kill right there on a bubbles. Yeah, you talk about Slap though playing the Nymph 4. This is definitely, like I said, if he's going to be playing support, this
going
is
for report again.
One of his support heroes, and yeah, they're going to the top lane. But Electrician, never mind. I thought it was going to be too quick. But actually, he is still going to be caught right here. Bypasses the portal key on top of the flight. And electrician also going to be picked off. So that's where the strengths obviously still land very much so for Sync Esports. It's just the mobility and the movement and the catching you, the gotcha potential.
Yeah, Slap is having one of his best games on Honkast, I think. This is, he's playing out of his mind right now. Just really good play, controlling the map overall. Mm-hmm. His movement with the hero has been beautiful. From the start to the finish, and this Zeal Stones have been absolutely on top.
Yeah.
So well done by Slap so far. Really deserves a shout-out.
On the ball, indeed. So, again, you look back at recent gaming, Moon Queen has kind of gone back up a little bit, 343 gold per minute, and we all know what happens. If you have a Moon Queen, there is that slight chance.
No, wasn't it recent gaming, that game with the Doombringer as
it
well?
Was Reason Gaming the one that did it, or was it...
I think Reason Gaming was the Moon Queen team.
I think they were, yeah. I think they were the ones that came back. Who was it against? I'm blanking on it.
Wasn't it
Denial?
Denial?
Yeah, I think it was.
I think it was.
I think it might be this matchup. Obviously, different players to an extent, but still, there's a lot of these players...
I'm sure the memory haunts them.
Yes.
As a player, there are those things that you never forget. For me, it's always been going Kongor is super scary to me. Even if they're genocided, it's just scary because I've had a lot of bad experiences with that. So I'm sure they're worried about the Moon Queen. They don't want to throw any more fights like that. They know, guys, we're really far ahead. Just play it smart. Get our BKBs. Get our items. Mm-hmm. Don't throw this away. Because as soon as they have Shrunken Heads, it's gonna be a lot less damage coming out of the Moon Queen. She doesn't really do auto attack damage yet, and it's basically the magic damage that you need to fear.
Yeah.
So Shrunken Head soon on Madman, Shrunken Head on Master Arms should be coming up soon, unless he decides to go for Geometer's Bane, which I think is fine. Also divides up the Moon Queen damage quite a lot.
Yeah.
So.
That time is definitely coming quickly here. In fact, it's going to be done on Madman here after that tower push top lane. So yeah, you just talk about the damage mitigation on their side and the free roam they'll have in these team fights. Is pretty absurd in favor of Sync Esports. And then Master Arms again, another 3,200 gold saved up. So he is just about there when it comes to his farm. But they are protecting Moon Queen at all costs, obviously, especially against an M4 team that gotcha potential just in general that they have. It's understandable. Pyromancer basically is just holding Moon Queen's hand here. Electrician staying in the vicinity. You also got Bubbles nearby. So, yeah, really just all about supporting here. Wouldn't be surprised to see, you know, just tablets and Storm Spirits coming out here on the Legion side if we could even get to that. But...
I don't think they're ever going to get there, and this is the draft problem when you're placing an M4 as a farming team. You just simply aren't going to be able to have the time. You need to force the fights, and that's what makes Moon Queen so great. She's good at forcing the fights. She's a carry that goes late game. She kind of counters her own counter. She works against it, but it's just a shame they drafted the way they did. I think you'll feel like the hero's surrounding her. If it would have been a Keeper of the Forest instead of the Electrician, and probably... a Pebbles instead of the Bubbles, that would have been a great lineup, and they could have forced those early fights, and they could have won them. Mm-hmm. A little bit of a misdraft, and they're stuck in their gameplay now. They have to let the Nymphora just tear them apart by letting Sync farm much more than they're able to.
Yeah. So, there's the three Shrunken Heads now coming out. Master of Arms finishes his, so... I think it's going to be safe to say Sync Esports is going to be feeling pretty good here as far as trying to make something happen. And actually, Mavis going to the bottom lane, N4 TP's in. Moon Queen's going to be the target, of course. However, Protective Melody coming out very early on, but the Impel's in, it's all three. Here come the TP's though, and the Hellborn team actually. Sync is going to retreat for now. Will they go back in? 3 seconds on that portal key.
Plasmeister isn't here yet. That's why they backed off.
Okay.
Yeah.
Yeah, he was not there. He has his. He did use a Master's Call, but.
Oh no, man, if Panny Dance Floor is here. Oh, if Bubble Shell Surf, they did not see. Oh, they didn't see Slap. Yeah, they did.
The cup fills in. There we go. Slap is going to be picked off. So all of a sudden, it's a 5-4.
Moon Queen popped
four.
Eclipse, though. This is a good fight for Sync.
Yeah.
Moon Finale's there's no ulti up on Moon Queen.
Are they going to go for Kongra,
though?
They
didn't notice. They don't notice. Kongra's dead, but I think they could have initiated there. Such a shame that they didn't go in. Without the Moon Queen ulti, there's really not a ton of damage coming out of. The Legion side, and with the Shrunken Heads, I think they could have forced that fight, but here we go.
Yeah, they're going to run into them, but again, Sync Esports is just very scared to fight at this point. I mean, Pestilence is kind of low on mana now and low on life. He's doing the Ancient, so it may be understandable there, but yeah, you can definitely say Sync Esports missing out on an opportunity where giving them a little too much credit with what they had. Good to go for that fight, so.
They had a double damage on MOA as well. Ah, that was such a missed team fight. I think that was definitely a a game-breaking teamfight, and if you're playing, say, Green or BMG, and they make a mistake like that, it's gonna hurt them hard.
Yeah.
But yeah, no, it looks like they're getting, nothing's gonna happen out of it, but Denial continue to be really, really far ahead. And it really is all thanks to Slap this game. He is controlling the map perfectly. The hero was picked for him, which is, I suppose, a little bit thanks to Flensmeister as well then. But yeah, no, the Nip 4 are really, really making work. That's why they have the 15,000 gold lead already.
Yeah. Yeah, it's you're always on that tension, though. If you're going up against a Moon Queen here, it's having decent success, and no matter what lead you have. Again, we've already kind of referred to that, so not to keep going back to it too much, but it is still there. 1,900 gold saved up on Madman now. He is a carry potential hero that obviously is very scary himself, both in looks as well as what he brings to the table. So Pestilence has that Soul's Bulwark here on top of Fish Dragon and Portal Key, so even more amp damage for the team. They're going to go over to the Legion Ancients, actually, which happen to be double stacked.
Yeah, this is a typical Denial play, Sync play as well. They do emphasize a lot on farm control, and stealing the animations is a great way to do it. Because you're removing 1,000 gold from their team and giving your own team 1,000 gold, basically, every time it's triple stacking you're farming it.
Pestilence going to be jumped right here. Here comes the response on Seal's Dead. It didn't really hit it best right there, I don't believe. Pestilence going to be picked up. Madman coming in. There goes the Protective Melody, though. Madman needs to be careful dropping fast. They will kill Rhapsody, though. Stop the Protective Melody. And now Electrician in the background. Moon Finale activated by Moon Coon right here. It's spreading a little bit. Master Barb's taking a good amount of the damage, but the creep's absorbing a lot as well. And off to the side once again. Electrician still being chased. He will try to port out, but with unsuccessful. I guess. And anyways, he gets picked off. So Nipura, he's going for the TP. Yep, they're going to try to catch the mob. Perfect placement right on top. Pyromancer's going to fall. They will save Moon Queen at least. But Pyromancer goes down. And again, so they got, I mean, the start was decent for Reason Gaming, really. They picked up Pestilence.
Not going to get a better start than that, really. But it's just the resources are huge. And Slap is playing so well.
Yeah.
And talk about a player that snowballs. Like, if he goes into the Thailand qualifier like this, playing this hype, he's going to do amazing at LAN. I can see it before me. This is the kind of player that, if he's in a good mood, he'll play amazingly. And when he's not, he is just absolute garbage. So it's nice to see him in form and in shape like this right before the big event.
Yeah, you know, for not only their success, but just the overall, for the goodness of the event, that, you know, he definitely has
The
positive hype going in, no doubt. So, no doubt playing very, very well. And again, as a team, it's just, and again, they're in a unique situation as they are playing with a new fifth. It's kind of new fifth, but not really. I mean,
yeah, exactly.
Go ahead.
I mean, I was going to dare say it. I think they're better with Mickey than Probusk.
Because. Remember, I mean, Mickey, when he initially left, that Keizu's actually the one that replaced Mickey. And, you know,
yeah.
A lot of people are fans. I personally was a huge fan of that for the sake of the team. And I think of that show. I mean, he brought a lot of experience that he's had. And obviously just a great player. Played the suicide role very well. But Mickey now replaced in Probusk. And I've also been hinted at that Mickey prefers more of this position over the suicide position as far as the role goes. So, you know, maybe that has something to do with it as well. Probusk is a great player. I honestly think Probusk, you know, definitely brought a lot to the table for their team. But at the same time, hey, it wasn't working out, then it wasn't working out, obviously. So, and Mickey, no doubt, a very, very good replacement to find. Again, it's not 100% official yet, so I don't want to put that out there. But we're still waiting for that confirmation.
Yeah, no, I mean, Probusk definitely, I've had this discussion with multiple players. I think he's a great player, but in my opinion, I don't really feel like he has a very unique play style. He doesn't really move from his lane much. He doesn't create much space for the team. He's more the kind of player that he considers himself a carry, and he's going to farm. And more so counter gank whenever an opportunity occurs. And with Keizu and Flensmeister on the team, both players that are like that will want to farm. They want a lot of space. I really felt like it didn't fit. Whereas Mickey is much more active, and he's the kind of guy that will be like, hey guys, let's do something. This is boring.
Kills,
I want to force something. This sucks. And I think that just does it. It's just so good for the team to get some movement into this stale kind of playstyle that I think both Keizu and Flensmeister, they like to play the static game. They like to play the long game. And you can tell by Denial's playstyle and what they do best that's what they're good at.
Yeah.
Taking the farm games, taking the map control game, playing the heroes like Nymphora, and using stuff like the Empath Wall to block camps and just really winning over time.
Madman, he's got a Brutalizer token alive. Here we go. He's going to be jumping right here. Look at that Berserk, though, going off the charts. But Protective Melody in the background. It is going to go good duration right there, but Moon Queen's going to fall shortly after as soon as it goes off. Yeah, you just see as soon as it wears off, it's like, oh, she's dead all of a sudden. She does buy back. Hattrick already coming out there for Keizu. He is getting low, but again, he has a token alive, so worst case scenario, he resurrects.
Oh,
stop the
God.
Chase with the move finale. Oh. Beautiful response coming in from Mickey right there. Bubble's going to end up falling. Down goes Moon Queen. Is it going to be Annihilation? No, it's not, actually. He doesn't get it. Support gets the kill. So no Annihilation just yet. He could still get it if he gets a Pyromancer, maybe, but oh, he's not low enough, so I don't think it's going to happen. But I think it's safe to say Sink is on the way to a win here.
What a man down. He could have, should have gone for it when he got heard the quad kill sound and just go in. He had the token of life up, so.
Yeah.
Yeah, disappointed in Keizu. No, but overall, it's just looking overwhelming here. The golden advantage is huge for Sync Esports. And they got the Racks. You saw that Moon Queen. She just got annihilated. I was thinking that Rhapsody wasn't really that good. And then it wore off, and I was like, oh, damn, that was, wow. And yeah, no, there's absolutely no way, and I know this is Super Caster's Curse, but like, there is no way Reason Gaming wins this game.
There's no way. It's
there's absolutely no way.
As you see those right clicks right there. Savage,
I mean, I think,
Mace and a Wingbow.
I literally think it's at the point where you could grab the entirety of the Hellborn team and just A ground inside of the Legion base and they'd still just win the game.
Yeah.
I just don't get it. Like, it's so demoralizing and boring at this point if you're Reason Gaming and you're, like, playing support. Like, why just concede? Get more practice. Ugh.
It's over, man. It's game over.
Yeah, exactly. Just tap out. There's no reason to drag it on. But I mean, I suppose it's the last game in a best of five.
Yeah.
For the potential to compete for $50.
Heyo.
So.
Yeah, so no. They got that going for them, but again, it's like we're talking about Reason Gaming, not a team to concede, and just going to play it out. It's a final game, if anything. I don't know if they're going to scrim or whatever after this. So.
Yeah.
But for now, it's like, yeah, let's just finish off and maybe just play this out. I will say there are, at the same time, maybe in this case, what I want to concede, but I will say there are times, too, like when the team's being pushed into the base and they're about to finish it with killing the shrine. The team like concedes like right before that happens. It's like just not to finish the game. I mean,
yeah.
But
yeah.
Again, so here we have though Reason Gaming. They are going to 0-5 group up and push out the bottom lane.
It looks like a final push, and I like this much more than what I normally do, whereas they just sit in base.
Yeah, exactly.
For 15 minutes and just do nothing. they're forcing a final push to see if they can get a really good team fight execution. Something goes their way, they could always still win the game. That's basically what they're thinking. And I think that's fine. Oh, beautiful blacking bar from...
You mean a shrunken head.
That's what I meant to say. And I even said the full name.
I don't know why you said the full name. That just doesn't make sense.
I don't even know.
Anyways, right here, shrunken head going to be popped by Madman. There's that jump from Pestilence. And again, you said the predictive melody, but just like last time, as soon as that wears off, Moon Queen is going to be very vulnerable. Another quad kill. Can he get the annihilation this time? Concede. No, he gets the annihilation. He gets it. And there's the vote to concede, so that's a fun finish at least. But GG, well played. Game number 4 will go to Sync Esports, and they will officially take the series 3-1. So congratulations, Sync Esports. Again, they're going to be moving on now to play Stay Green on Thursday, actually. At least that's what it's scheduled for now. And they're going to be playing Stay Green in a best out of 5, most likely on Thursday for the title fight here for King of the Hill. That's going to be a good one yet again.
Definitely is. I mean, I've been looking at their scrims, and I think Sync Esports beat SG 5 times in a row yesterday.
Yeah.
So, yeah, definitely going to be an exciting series. I mean, if anything, SG is one of those teams that you don't really know until you play them in a tournament. But still, 5 times, it's quite impressive.
Yeah, no, I mean, nothing like momentum, if anything. Whether if that's actually going to mean something, you know, going into the World Finals in terms of, oh, Stagrin's falling apart going into it, but... you know, maybe not, but momentum for Sync Esports definitely, and yeah, as you said, they beat them in that. So we'll see how they fare on Thursday. And again, more of a tournament environment, as there is, you know, may not be the most, but there is still something on the line there for the two teams. But how about KZ2? 16-1-12 as far as his final hero kill stats. So as well as 121 APM. Never really got that, man. KZ2, known as one of the lowest APM players. APM is everything, in my opinion. All right, I was we were planning to actually, before we got to wrapping things up here, Zlapt did want to come on and do a post-game interview, so I'm actually just trying to hit him up and see if he is going to be good for that, so I'll just give another minute here to see if we can make that happen before officially wrapping things up. But again, another good... What's that?